Did you know Nevada ranks number 3 in the nation when it comes to earthquakes that can cause damage? Follow me as I go back to school today.
I was very close to the epicenter of the 1994 Northridge earthquake, and that truly is a mind-shattering event. So when I heard that Dr. Wanda Taylor out of UNLV was out here in the Nevada desert with her students looking for active fault lines so close to Las Vegas, I said, oh man, I'm all in on that one.
My teacher is geology professor Wanda Taylor. I'm joining her graduate class as they do some field work.
Hey, Wanda. How are you?
Good. Hi, John.
Nice seeing you.
Nice to see you.
Is this the class?
Yeah, this is my graduate class.
Well, I wish this was my school classroom when I was going to school.
It's awesome.
This class studies the earthquake fault line located in the California Wash Reservoir, first recognized by Chester Longwell in the 1930s.
What we're trying to do is study an active fault. Southern Nevada has several active faults. No one has studied this fault in detail before, although it's been known since the 1930s. So we're trying to get more detailed data and more modern information to look at when it was active and how active it
is. So you're not just out here practicing this stuff. I mean, you're collecting real data that other people don't have.
Correct.
Wow.
Yeah, absolutely new things.
Can you show me what a fault looks like out here?
Sure, we can do that.
All right.
Nevada has thousands of quaternary faults, which are faults that may cause earthquakes.
So here's my question for you. How do you know that this is what we're looking at is an active fault?
There's two or three reasons. So the first reason is that the fault makes an escarpment that's part of the current landscape. So that has to be very young for it not to have been eroded away. And then the other thing is that these materials right here, these sediments, are very young in age. In terms of geology, these things are 4,000, 2,000, 10,000 years old. And I'll show you that the fault cuts them.
These markings on the surface serve as indicators of what is happening down below.
You can observe a kind of linear feature going through here.
What, just this little gash right here?
Yeah, and you'll see that this bed right here, you see this kind of continuous layer.
Yeah.
And then it stops here, and you observe the continuous layer up here.
Right.
So this piece used to be connected, and the fault came through and lowered this here.
By measuring the distance these layers have moved, students like Michael Evans can estimate the strength of the last earthquake along this fault.
By identifying the age of all this and when this action happened, you can tell how active this fault is?
Exactly. So when was the last time this fault moved? How much did it move? And that's going to help us understand when could it move again.
And how strong that would be.
Yeah, exactly. Because when you measure, you know, this distance from here, you can calculate the actual movement along the fault and how much shaking there was.
What's your next step? What do you do here?
So with something like this, what we're doing out here today is we're actually going to set up a log of this. We're going to photograph it and place a grid, and then we are going to make a detailed profile of this and measure that offset, and then we're going to try to calculate how much shaking was from that earthquake.
Does this go deep into the ground or does it stop right here?
It potentially goes very deep into the ground.
Each year, thousands of earthquakes shake Nevada and Eastern California, but only 10 to 100 are strong enough for us to feel.
So this is Amanda. She's a graduate student at UNLV with us. And what she's doing is she is measuring the orientation of the fault. So she places the notebook in there to take the actual fault surface, and then she uses this geologic compass in order to measure its orientation to north and then the angle at which the fault is going down.
It has the perfect angle of 45 degrees.
Oh, perfect. It's kind of an idealized angle for faults oftentimes. When you see it in a textbook or you see it modeled and taught, these faults are often at very nice, clean 45 degree angles that are geometrically nice to work with. So that is going to help us know at this point it's 45 degree angle, and it's going to make the calculations very nice when we get back to the lab.
On average, earthquakes that represent potential damage happen every 3 years in this region.
He's taking a close look at that right there. What's he doing?
So Richie has a hand lens, and he's looking at the rock to understand where the rock has come from. So if we can understand what the rock is and where it's come from, then we can better understand when it was put here.
Here's what's amazing. I look at this and I see a dirt wall in a wash.
Sure.
You look at this and you see a whole story that goes back thousands and thousands of years.
Definitely.
I mean, this thing speaks to you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, see, I think the average person at home watching is probably saying, Michael, just give it to me. I live in Las Vegas. Am I at risk for a big earthquake or not?
You know, this research needs to be done to identify that, but if I just had to tell the viewers, what you really need to do is definitely prepare. You know, the risk might not be that great. It could be tomorrow, it could be 100,000 years. We don't understand exactly when it's gonna go off again, but what's important is that people understand that there can be earthquakes in Las Vegas, and that's what this research is trying to bring awareness to. People can be more safe, putting together a simple disaster kit in your home with some extra water, blankets, flashlights, you know, will make a big difference if this fault does move.
In case of an earthquake, drop, cover, and hold on. It also helps to have a 3-day supply of water and non-perishable food.
Professor Taylor. I know, you like Wanda, but I have to call you Professor Taylor. I just want to say thank you for letting us come out here and disrupt your class like this.
Well, it's great to have an opportunity to help Nevada, and Southern Nevada especially, become aware of earthquakes in the area and that we do have a hazard.
You did that today. Thank you so much.
Great.